Hello everyone, welcome to the new video on the series of NLP. In this video, we are going to discuss about lemmatization. In the previous video, we had discussed about stemming. But as I told you earlier that lemmatization is far better than stemming, but it takes more time. So guys, let's start exploring lemmatization. First of all, I am creating here an object of lemmatizer. Like previously, we had different types of stemming. We also have different type of lemmatizer, but here we are using WordNet lemmatizer. I will provide this notebook to you in the description. You can read more about WordNet by clicking on this link here. So guys, let's create the object of both stemmer and lemmatizer to compare them both. Now we can see the inbuilt functions and attributes of that lemmatizer. We are going to use lemmatize function. This is of our use. So guys, now let's see some difference between lemmatizer and stemmer. If we provide two words, meanness and meaning, to stemmer, let's see what stemmer will return both as mean. But as we know that meaning and meanness are far way different words, they don't mean the same. So we don't want them to return the same words. But that's not the case with lemmatizer. As you can see, while performing lemmatizer, it is taking some time, but it returns as we expected both words as different words, meanness and meaning, and that we want also. Similarly, if we use two different words, like one is singular and other is plural, like goose and geese, if we will use stemming, let's see what it returns. It is returning goose and geese. These both words don't have any meaning. They may be not any dictionary word. So stemming can return any word by removing suffixes or prefixes. The word is not necessary to be a dictionary word. But this is not the case with lemmatizer. Let's run this with lemmatizer. As you can see, lemmatizer has written both the word as goose. It means it is singular and plural, but means we can treat both the word as same. So the lemmatizer is doing the same job. Guys, here was the brief differentiation between lemmatizer and stemming. I hope you had understand why lemmatizer is better than stemming. Now in the next part, we will do the same thing that we done in the stemming part. I am not going to explain this part of code as I had done in earlier videos. You can watch that video if you are new to this channel. I am just importing the data set and providing the labels as label and body tags. As you can see in the output, guys, here we have two columns, label and body tags. Now this is also the same code from the previous tutorial. In one function, we are clearing the text, like we are removing punctuation, we are removing the extra characters, then we are removing the stop words, and finally we are returning the text. And we are adding a new column, body tags, no stop, where this pre-processing will be done. Now in the last step, guys, we had created a function lemmatizing. As I discussed earlier, we had a huge variety of lemmatizer, but in this video we are specially discussing about WordNet lemmatizer. So guys, similar to stemming, we had first created an object here in the first part of WN. This is the object of the WordNet lemmatizer, and we are using the function lemmatize and passing each word from this tokenized text to this function. So what will lemmatize do? It will take one word by word and it will lemmatize that word, means it will return the root form of that word. And I am creating a new column, body text lemmatize. It will contain all the words lemmatize. Let's run this code. As you can see, guys, in the previous video I told you that there was some disadvantage with stemming. This entry was interpreted as entry in stemming, but this is not the case with lemmatization. As you can see, lemmatization is far better than stemming. So if you have a huge amount of data, you can go with stemming, because lemmatization will be a slow process. And if you are focusing more on accuracy, then lemmatizer is the best you can do with that. So guys, I hope you had understand this video, and if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to like the video. In the next tutorial series, we will talk about vectorization. Vectorization is a further process, and there are a few more vectorizer types like count vectorizer and gram vectorizer. We will talk about that also. And guys, in this cleaning text process, I discuss Potter stammer and WordNet lemmatizer. There are also different types of stammer and lemmatizer. You can explore that, but I discuss only the efficient or the most used lemmatizer and stammer. I hope guys you would understand the video. Summarizing, lemmatizer is better than stemming, but lemmatizer is slower or it takes more processing time than stemming. So guys, it's your choice which text cleaner you want to use, lemmatizer or stemmer. So guys, see you in the next video. Till then, keep learning.